5 seconds to go. Start. It has given me great pleasure to have been able to visit the gold mines this morning. I have wandered about this country a great deal and also visited this state on 3 previous occasions. But I have visited the gold mines for the first time this morning. You can therefore easily understand how happy I am to have seen many things which I did not see before. I had seen many mines, some of which operate in the state from which I come. There I had seen coal mines, copper mines, iron mines, mica mines, but I had not seen a gold mine because it does not exist elsewhere. So it was a matter of real pleasure that I came here and saw the working of the gold mines in your area. In this country, nature has endowed us with a great deal of wealth which is hidden in the bowels of the earth. We have not been able so far to get a correct and exact picture of what there is under the earth. The government is engaged in setting up some sort of an organization which will investigate and estimate our mineral resources. Work in this line has been going on, but it is intended to intensify it so that we may go ahead in this direction. It is therefore a matter for congratulation that you are doing this kind of work and have been able to strike new fields which you consider to be quite satisfactory from the point of view of work and profit. You have no reason to apprehend that the government will do anything which will stand in the way of the development of this important industry. We are anxious to develop all our resources. It takes a little time for all governments to make up their minds, and especially when they have not all the necessary knowledge and information to enable them to form a correct decision on points. I understand a committee has been appointed which is going to look into all the aspects of this question so far as these mines are concerned, and I hope the recommendations of the committee will be such as well help further progress and development of these industries. It is in the interest of the government, it is in the interest of the workers, it is in the interest of the companies so far. It has given me great pleasure to go round the town which has grown up in this place, which you said at one time was nothing but barren rocks. I have seen at Jamshedpur, and probably there are several other places like this where, on account of development of modern industries, townships have grown up, and this is one of them where there were jungles before. I think some of you might have seen Jamshedpur. Jamshedpur was nothing but dense jungle about 45 years ago. It was then very largely inhabited by wild elephants. In the same place, we have today the biggest city in the province and the biggest steel factory in Asia. It often happens that when one industry grows up in a particular place, other subsidiary industries grow up along with it. From the experience of Jamshedpur, I can say that you can also look forward to the development of other subsidiary industries in your area. There are at Jamshedpur, I think, more men employed in the subsidiary industries than in the main industry, because whereas the main iron and steel works is one factory, which of course is a very big factory, there are large numbers of other industries round about the main factory, and they all employ large numbers of workers. Our village folk, although simple and mostly uneducated, were able to pick up the technical work. I believe that has been your experience also. A considerable proportion of the labor population here comes from the Madras Presidency and other local areas. The fact that the ordinary people are taking to modern industries gives us hope that our industries will prosper. For once the problem of trained technicians is overcome, the problem of finding, organizing, and directing skill will not present much difficulty. In any case, if necessary, we could get such specialized talent from outside. We are anxious for the growth of all industries. I am sure you also realize that for the growth of industries, it is necessary that our labor is contented and it feels secure. If that is borne in mind, I am sure with your experience and skill, you have no reason to fear that this industry would close down for want of support, or that this place will once again be inhabited by lizards and jackals. I am sure, God willing, it will continue to prosper. I thank you all for the kindness shown to me and for taking me around and showing all the places. I am particularly thankful to the people who have come out in their thousands on the roadside to greet me. Stop.